In this video, let's see how to enable Hetzner Firewall for your cloud server. This is my server. I can try to log in. Right now you see I'm able to access the server. The fact that it's asking for a password means I'm able to access the server. So let me just do Ctrl C to get out of that. We're going to enable the firewall. There on your servers, just click on it and come here under firewalls. You can create a firewall. So I'm going to create a new firewall. But first of all, you need to work with inbound rules. So most rules are actually inbound. Being able to access the server, by default, all outbound rules are allowed. The moment you create an outbound rule, all outbound rules will be dropped by default, except for the ones you allow right here. In most cases, you're probably just going to leave that empty to allow all outbound rules. Outbound rules are rules that are coming from your server to the outside world. So the ones that are usually causing problems are usually the ones that are coming from the world to your server. People trying to access your server. Those are the inbound rules. So in this case, you can see the TCP port 22. The moment you see port 22, and it's allowing IPv6 from any IPv4 or any IPv6, this is the default SSH port. So if you have a different SSH port, you'd create that port. Just to test that the firewall is actually enabled, I'm going to delete the SSH port. Let's just say, for example, we add a rule here allowing any IPv4, allowing any IPv6, and it is of type TCP. We want it to be for HTTP. So I'm just going to select HTTP. Maybe you also want to allow HTTPS. Allow HTTPS. All right. So those two, remember I've disabled SSH, so we won't be able to SSH into our server. You can apply the firewall to any server within the same project. If you add a label selector, the firewall will automatically be activated on any server with the matching labels. So when you're deploying Hetzner servers, you can usually add a label, and that's what they mean here. But in this case, we can manually select a resource and we'll click on server and we can select that specific server and apply to that server. Labels. So if your servers have labels, you can put that label here. You can give this a label and then it will automatically attach to any resource with that label. Of course, I want to give it a name and I'm just going to call it sample. The moment I click on create firewall, and the firewall turns to applied, and I come to my terminal and I try to access this server, it won't be able to access it until I allow the SSH port. So you can see this is going to continue for a while. It's going to try. It's not going to work. But if I was to ping, let's confirm if pinging is allowed. Okay, ICMP seems like it's allowed. So if you don't want your server to be pinged, you can come in here and delete that. In this case, this is just going to continue for a while until it fails. So I'm just going to Ctrl C and I can try to ping the server. If I ping it, it should work because ICMP is allowed. Ctrl Shift C, Ctrl Shift V, enter. You can see the server is telling you that it is live. Ctrl C. If I was to come back here and edit the firewall, just click there on the three dots and you can edit the firewall. You can click there to add a rule and we're going to add port 22. And then save, and now we should be able to SSH into our server. Control L. And we can enter our password and also test the HTTP ports. Control L. Maybe if I do DNF install Nginx. So right now, if we were to access the port, access the IP. Oh, do you want to? Yes, type Y and enter to install Nginx. Nginx is installed. So let's try to go to the IP. doesn't support secure connection, continue to site with HTTP. And this is probably because Nginx is not enabled. Let's confirm. Service Nginx status. So you can see it's not enabled. So we can enable it. Service Nginx. Oh, instead of doing all this, let me just do system CTL enable dash dash now Nginx. Right, so after doing that, and we do status again, so Nginx is enabled and running. And if we try to reload, it's showing us the default page for Nginx for Fedora. All right, so if we come back to our firewall, and on the firewall, let us delete the HTTP port, save changes, and then come and reload. I'll open it in a brand new private tab. Paste and go. Okay. Continue to site. So here it's not working. That's because the port has been closed. So if you want to allow it again, we are going to add a rule, and we're going to add the rule for port 80. I can select that, save changes. And which browser was it? If I try to continue to site, this time it works after enabling the port. That's how to work with the Hetzner firewall. But just because you have the Hetzner firewall enabled doesn't mean you shouldn't install a firewall on your server. So make sure you install a firewall on your server as well. If you're on Ubuntu, you can just use UFW. It's not a problem. If you're on Fedora, you can use NF tables. I think NF tables comes by default. Let's confirm service tables status. Okay, not found. Is it firewall D that comes by default? But it doesn't matter because you can install whichever firewall you're used to using. So make sure you install a firewall, IP tables. Install NF tables. Y, enter. And you can pick it from there. Oh, something else, if you're on Kubernetes and you need to allow port range, you just enter the first port and the next port. Maybe you want to allow port 30,000 to 32K, and make sure there are no empty rules down here. They'll prevent you from saving. So if anything is empty, just delete it and then save. And even before we end here, let's say you have another one, and for this, you want to allow a specific IP. You want to allow a specific IP, maybe 192.168.30.89. So maybe you want to allow that IP to accept port 77. You can do so. If you want to learn more about the Hetzner firewall, just go to the Hetzner documentation. And that's it for this one. If you have any questions, feel free to let me know.